Good day to you, sir. My name is Alfred Banks, and...
Whatever it is you're selling, I'm not interested.
Ah, but I'm not here to sell you anything. In fact, quite the contrary.
Oh, I see. Merrick sent you, didn't he?
Well, yes, he did.
Look, you can go back and tell him exactly what I told all the others. Nothing doing. I bought this land before he got his little vision, and I intend to keep it. I tried appeasing him by building my house to match his Mediterranean style, but apparently even that wasn't good enough. I did everything by the book and filed all the proper paperwork. You tell Merrick he'll get me off this land when I'm no longer drawing breath. Good day to you, sir.
That was interesting. Let's, try this again?
You again? What do you want?
Take a guess.
Sir, I really just want to have a chat.
I know your game. You vipers are just trying to trick me, and before I know it, you'll be flim-flamming me into signing some paper handing over my land. Well, you can just forget it. I've worked too hard on this house to just let it go. The paperwork alone was a nightmare and a half. Nothing you can say will convince me to sell my land. Nothing. Good day to you, sir.
What a nice gentleman. Wait a second. I need to check up on something.
Hello, sir. Let me know if I can be of assistance.
Will do. Portray. The portrays of a distinguished-looking older gentleman. The plaque at the bottom identifies him as H.M. Flagler. Rules and regulations. A large list of rules and regulations is hanging on the wall in a glass frame. You begin to read them over, but quickly lose interest. You were never very tolerant of bureaucracy. Record shelves. The record shelves contain several volumes of records, but you get the feeling this is merely the tip of the iceberg. Filing cabinet? It's a standard metal filing cabinet, presumably full of more records. Sign? The sign identifies this place as the Hall of Records. Records clerk. The Hall of Records clerk is a shifty looking man, but hopefully he's good at his job. Hopefully he is.
Excuse me.
What can I do for you?
Can you tell me more about the records you keep?
What sort of records do you keep in this office?
All kinds. Marriage licenses, death certificates, property titles, you name it.
How far back do they go?
Not too far back. 30 years or so. The city wasn't officially incorporated until 1896, but I have some records going back to 1891. You let me know if there's anything you need to look up.
Interesting. Have you always lived in Miami?
Have you always lived in Miami?
Nah. I moved down here from Philly after the war. Nice place. Can't beat the climate, that's for sure.
Well, that's true.
Could I look something up?
Of course. What do you need?
There's a house at 1251 Anastasia Avenue that I need some information on.
Of course. Let me go have a look. Yes, here we are. Belongs to one Ernest Mathers. Built it himself 6 months ago.
Might I have a copy of the document?
What's your business with it?
I'm working with Mr. George Merrick of the Coral Gables project, and it's of utmost importance to his acquisition of the land.
All right, you can take this copy.
Thank you for your help.
Anytime.
Thank you for your time. Let's have a look at the records.
You take a look through the records for the 1251 Anastasia House and see that it was constructed 6 months ago by Ernest Mathers. According to this, he had a cursory inspection performed. Looking further, you see that there were no permits pulled for any of the construction work done. Mathers may have tried to appease Merrick, but it seems he did so in a very half-assed fashion. Holy smokes. Just what I need. Let's get back to him. He's not going to like me very much. But for the record, I found a way.
again. What do you want?
Well, to explain this simply...
Mr. Mathers, I've just been to the Hall of Records downtown, and I pulled up a copy of your house record.
Yes, and?
It seems you had a property inspection done when you completed the house, but it was very basic. Furthermore, you didn't pull any construction permits.
I didn't need to. I haven't done any exterior work.
Nevertheless, I'm afraid I'll need to perform an inspection of your home just as a matter of record.
On what authority?
Look, you can either let me come in and do a brief home inspection, or I can report you to the county, and you can deal with whatever fine or punishment they see fit to dispense.
Fine. Come in. I don't know what you expect to find, though.
Instructions show the room for violations listed at the bottom. Click on the spot where you think you have found one. If you are correct, the area will be marked with a red circle and the item will disappear from the list. Continue until all items have been found. Let's go through the list. Water damage. Mold. There we go. Mold.
Quite a nasty buildup of mold you have here.
My wife told me she'd clean it up.
Yeah.
This wall shows clear signs of water damage. You probably have a cracked pipe somewhere back there.
Oh, I suppose that would explain it.
That would explain it indeed.
What a mess! You clearly have a problem with a water leak.
And I've called the plumber, but he's yet to get back to me.
Sure.
Uneven rafters are quite the hazard. This whole roof could come tumbling down on you.
Haven't had any problems so far.
So far.
Nice gazebo. I hope you know you need to have a permit to have one of those.
It was a wedding gift from my sister. How was I meant to know?
Ignorance of rules is no excuse, Mr. Mathers.
What do we have
here? Your fireplace seems to be letting go of some of its tiles.
Oh. Yes, I've been meaning to fix those.
Your floor tiles are severely cracked here. Do you regularly have elephants as houseguests?
No. I mean, my mother-in-law hasn't seen the new house yet.
Ha ha ha.
That was a joke.
I'm sure it was. These baseboards look like they were installed during the Roosevelt administration.
No, they're supposed to look like that. It's the style, makes them seem classic.
You seem to have several problems in this home. Are you sure you performed a thorough inspection?
Well, yes. Yeah, I'm sure I did.
I see. And who was it that performed this inspection exactly?
Why, it was a man. Yes, a man from the city.
And did you happen to get this man's name?
Well, no, I wasn't aware of...
You didn't really have an inspection performed, did you?
No. I paid someone to say they had done one on the public record. You won't tell anyone, will you?
You're in quite a state here, Mr. Mathers. Not only did you build this house without the proper permits, but you also put fraudulent information on your report. This doesn't look good any way you cut it.
Please, I have money. How much to get you to look the other way?
I'm afraid my silence can't be bought, Mr. Mathers. However, you might be able to get yourself out of this jam if you sell your house and land to Mr. Merrick.
So this is what it's come to. I see how it is. You come in here, play in the White Knight, but you're no better than any of the rest of them. I did what I had to do to keep my land, but I suppose that was all for naught. Fine. I'll call up Mr. Merrick and tell him he's won. I hope you can live with yourself, you snake.
I'm sure I'll manage. Have a nice afternoon, sir.
Now that matter has been dealt with. Let's move forwards and onwards to the Miami Herald.
Quite an operation they've got going on in here.
Hello, sir. Let me know if I can help you with anything.
I will. Memo boards. The bulletin board contains several memos and notes for all the Herald employees. framed newspaper. There is a framed newspaper on the wall. It seems to be about the day the Great War ended.